Photoshop is a powerful tool that in the beginning can be extremely stressful and intimidating. It takes a long time to learn the program, although I'm going to show you the essential tips that you need for architecture. It'll help you establish a strong foundation so that you can create, manipulate, and edit photos like a pro. All right, so let's get to it. Hey everybody, so right now I just opened Photoshop and over on the left-hand side, let's go ahead and click New File. 8.5 by 11 inches should be okay for this tutorial. Go ahead and click Create. All right, so now we have opened a blank canvas at 8.5 by 11 inches. Over on the right-hand side of your screen, at the bottom, you'll see a little tab that says Layers. Layers is a very critical panel inside of Photoshop, and probably the most used panel. A lot of famous architects like Mies van der Rohe, Zaha Hadid, Frank Lloyd Wright, and Frank Gehry all used collaging. And Photoshop is just like a digital collage. In your Layers panel, at the bottom right, you'll see a plus sign. Go ahead and click that, and that's going to create a new layer. Now that layer sits on top of your background layer. So what we can do is we can go ahead and drag an image into this. Okay, so I've simply opened up my folder and clicked and dragged the image into the Photoshop canvas. So at this point, you can scale your image, rotate it, and do whatever you'd like to it before you press enter. I'm going to go ahead and make it a little bit larger by clicking and dragging on this corner box and pressing enter. So now we have Elon Musk looking pretty good. Over on the right-hand side, you can see that Elon Musk is on the layer that's above our background layer. Let's go ahead and select our background layer. So right now, if you were to drag a background onto this, you'll notice that it doesn't let you. That's because this layer is locked. Over on the right-hand side of this layer, you'll see a padlock. Go ahead and click that to unlock it. Now let's drag in our background. All right, it's a beautiful sunny day with Elon Musk. Go ahead and press enter. So inside of our layers panel, you'll see that Elon Musk is now in front of the sunny day. We can turn Elon Musk on and off, metaphorically. And we can also turn the background on and off. If we wanted Elon to be behind the background, we can simply click and drag his layer below it. Now he's hidden. Let's bring him back up to the front. So in Photoshop, it's very important that you worked in a non-destructive manner, meaning if we go over here to the brush tool and select red, and we color while we have the Elon Musk layer selected, it'll draw directly on that layer. We don't really want to do that. Let's go ahead and undo that. What we want to do is we want to create a new layer on top of that. Let's go ahead and double-click the name and name it Brush. Press enter. Now we can draw over Elon. As you can see now, we can turn this brush layer on and off, and it never damages the layer with Elon Musk in it. So I'm not really digging that red brush stroke. Let's go ahead and delete it. Click and drag it down to the trash can at the bottom right. One of the best ways to work in a non-destructive manner in Photoshop is to use masks. At the bottom, this icon here, go ahead and click it. This adds a layer mask onto your layer. So now you can see on the Elon Musk layer, we have Elon to the left and a mask to the right. If we go over here to our brush tool, select it, and let's change our color to black. Press OK. Now you can see we have the mask selected. Now if we come over here and paint on the white background, it'll make it disappear. So whatever you paint in black on a layer mask, it'll actually hide it. And the opposite can be said for white. Let's go over here and click this little switch icon. And now if we paint, it'll bring it back. Just remember the white and black kind of acts like light. If white represents the light and black represents the shadows, then it kind of makes sense. You can't see in the shadows. So let's use black and get rid of some of Elon Musk's background here. Wow, it's looking better already. For our third step, let's look at adjustment layers. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see the tab Adjustments. Go ahead and click that tab. And just so you know, if your Photoshop workspace looks nothing like mine, check out the link that I just put up there. It'll show you how to create the best and most efficient workspace for architecture. Okay, let's go back over to the Adjustments panel. And here you have a lot of options, like brightness, contrast, levels, black and white. You can even invert it. All right, let's go over to Brightness and Contrast and just click it. As you can see, I added a Brightness and Contrast adjustment layer, and this sits on top. Whatever is below this layer will be affected by its settings. So if we click and drag this brightness slider up, it'll make everything brighter. If we drag it down, it'll make everything darker. Let's go ahead and set this back to 0. A quick tip, if you don't want it to affect everything below it, hover right here in between the two layers and hold your Alt key. And you'll see the mouse change to this icon. Go ahead and click. And now it's only affecting the layer right below it. So if we wanted to turn the brightness up now, only Elon is affected. Let's give him a little tan. Looking good. All right, let's check out what tools we got. Over on the left-hand side is your toolbar. I would recommend just hovering over each one for a moment, and Photoshop is really nice. It gives you this little tutorial on how to use the tools. If you click the Move tool here, and go over and select the Elon Musk layer, you can move him around. Let's put him more in the frame. And now go over to your Layers panel, hold Shift, and click the sunny day layer as well. Let's go ahead and move it to the bottom of the screen. Now over on the left-hand side is your crop tool. Let's go ahead and click that. And now you can see your crop boundaries came up around your canvas. Let's click at the top here and drag it down so it aligns with our background. And now press Enter. Let's go over to the Layers panel and delete the mask that we created earlier. Just click it and press Delete. Now over on the left-hand side, you'll see your Object Selection tool. Click it. Now, with the Elon Musk layer selected, click and drag a box around him. As you can see, Photoshop automatically selected him. Now let's go up to Select at the top in the title bar, and then go to Inverse. Now press Delete. Look at that, now he fits right in. There's actually one more important item over in your Layers panel, and it's the blending modes. This is very important for architecture. Let's throw some buildings and a bird in there, because no architectural drawing is complete without buildings, and especially the birds. All right, so now I'm going to click and drag in this building I found by Glenn Merkitt, and press Enter. And now, as you can see, this brightness and contrast layer is affecting it. I don't like that. Let's go ahead and delete that by clicking and dragging it down to the trash can at the bottom. Let's do the same thing to this building that we did to Elon. Go over to the left-hand side and click the Object Selection tool. Click and drag it around the building. Go to Select in the title bar and click Inverse. And now let's delete the background. Oh, look at that. It could not complete your request because a smart object is not directly editable. That's okay. Go over to your layer and right-click it and rasterize it. Now press Delete. Perfect. And you can deselect by holding Control and pressing D. Select your Move tool and click it. We can drag it around. Elon is in the way, so let's put this building behind him. Now, we can still move the building, even though Elon is in the front. If we hold Control and press T, that's our Transform tool. Or, you can go over here to your Rectangular Marquee tool, click and drag it around your selection, right-click, and press Free Transform. Now, let's scale this down so it fits in the perspective a little bit better. Move it around. Perfect. Press Enter. And hold Control and press D to deselect it. That looks quite terrible, but I think you get the point. And last but not least, we need some birds. I'm going to click and drag in my birds, and make sure you have a PNG. Otherwise, you're going to have to go through and use the Object Selection tool and delete the background every image. We're going to want this a little bit smaller. Let's put it in front of the sun for some good effect. Press Enter. Beautiful. All right, so I'm sitting here in the studio and I'm realizing a lot of y'all are looking at this like, what are we making? This looks like a super basic image. Yes, I agree, but we have to start somewhere. In order to make images like this, and like this one, and like that one, we gotta start with something simple as this. All right, just trust me on this one. Let's keep going. Let's rename our layers because organization is very important. This is our background. This is our house. This is our birds. And this is Elon. Now let's go to house, into the blending modes. Let's see if any of these look a little bit better. Multiply looks all right. You can also adjust its opacity. If it has a high opacity, it'll be more solid. The lower the opacity, it'll be more transparent. In order to have a very quick and efficient workflow in Photoshop, you're going to want to learn the shortcuts. If you hover over your tools on the left-hand side, you can see it actually tells you what the shortcut key is for that. And over here at the top, if you select any of these items, a lot of them have shortcuts as well. One method I find to be very efficient is whenever you learn a new shortcut, write it down on a little sticky note and put it on your monitor screen, so that way you can always refer back to it quickly. All right, let's go ahead and save this. Go up to File. Click Save. I'm going to save it to the desktop. Let's name it Elon's House. As you can see, it's going to save it as a PSD. This is Photoshop's format. Go ahead and click Save. Perfect. Now, let's say you wanted to export this as a JPEG. Go up to File. Let's save a copy. Elon's House copy. And change the format to JPEG. And click Save. Quality maximum, click OK. All right, and there you have it, the very basics of Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, y'all. I hope that you got something out of it, and thank you for sticking around. Let me know down in the comments below if you have any suggestions for future videos. If you like the video, please like the video and consider subscribing if you want to see some future content.
Can this twist? I bet if you just did this like this. Test, 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 test.